Hello and welcome to the session in which we would look at the concept of purchase commitment. What is purchase commitment? Well, companies, what they do is they plan ahead, and as a result, they might sign contract to purchase material before production start because they want to secure the material. Therefore, they will enter into a contract to purchase material, and that could happen a month in advance, or could be a year in advance, or sometime 2 years in advance. At this point, the company don't recognize any asset or liability because no title has been transferred. However, if the contract is, we have to determine whether the contract is cancelable or non-cancelable. If the contract is cancelable, it's water under the bridge because you can cancel it. You don't have to worry about anything. If the contract to purchase is non-cancelable, the minimum you have to do, if the contract is material, you have to disclose this to let the users of the financial statements, the investors, the creditors, know that you have an upcoming contract, a large upcoming contract. What happens if the contract to purchase, which is your purchase commitment, is non-cancelable and the price of that contract is greater than the market price? What does that mean? It means you sign a contract to purchase something for $1 million. And that same thing now is worth $800,000. Your contract price is greater than the market price. Well, you are expecting a loss. If you are expecting a loss, what should you do? You should record the loss. You should recognize the loss and the period when such loss taking place. And this is based on the matching principle. You want to recognize the loss and the period that it occurs, and you want to be conservative because you are expecting losses. You want to anticipate the losses there. As you are anticipating the losses, you record the losses. This topic is covered in intermediate accounting as well as the CPA exam. Whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I am a useful addition. I explain the material differently than your CPA review course. I go slower. I give you more examples. This is the benefit. This is the difference between me and your CPA review course. Once you use me with your CPA review course, you're going to do much, much better on the exam. I would say you will add 10 to 15 points because you understand the material better. And here's your risk. Try me for 1 month, 1 month of subscription to find out whether I can help you or not. If not, that's fine. You cancel. That's your maximum loss. Your potential gain is actually passing the exam. If not for anything, take a look at my website to find out how well or not well your university doing on the CPA exam. I do have resources for other college courses other than intermediate accounting, advanced accounting, cost accounting, governmental accounting, all other accounting courses. My CPA supplemental resources are aligned with your Becker, Roger, Gleam, and Wiley, so you can go back and forth between your CPA review course and my supplemental material. I also give you the access to 1,500 previously AICPA released questions with detailed solution. And some of these questions, I have video recording about them, video explanation. If you have not connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation. Like this recording, share it with others. Connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. The best way to illustrate this concept is to actually work an example. Let's assume on January 1st, X5, Adam entered into a non-cancelable contract to lease a land to extract oil for a price of $6 million. So Adam's expecting there's 100,000 in the land. It can extract 100,000 barrels, and the cost is $60. By the end of 20X5, you know, Adam did not have the chance to extract them because Adam was busy. The price of oil dropped, and as a result, the same contract is worth now $5 million. Simply put, most likely the cost is now, the price of the oil is lower. So the contract for the same piece of land is now $5 million. What would Adam have to do? Adam will have to debit an unrealized holding gain loss, which is a loss, goes to income, debit that $1 million, credit estimated liability to purchase a commitment $1 million. So this is basically a liability, and this is a loss, and the loss goes on the income statement. This is a loss on the income statement. In 20X6, Adam paid for the contract. Now, Adam would still have to pay $6 million. So what would be the entry? Adam will credit cash for $6 million, debit purchases or inventory for $5 million. And now, since Adam recognized a liability, they would reduce that liability for $1 million, because now it's assumed it's a liability. That's what he's paying for. Now let's assume, for the sake of illustration, that the lessor decided to give Adam a break and charge Adam $5.5 million for the lease rather than $6 million because oil prices dropped. Then Adam can reverse half of that. They can reverse $500,000 debit estimated liability, $500,000, and credit unrealized holding, basically reducing the loss because we still have a loss. It's not really a gain. We still have a loss of $500,000. Now, the best way to learn this is to work MCQs, work exercises, and this is what you should do. Go to my website, farhatlectures.com. Again, at the end of this recording, I'm going to remind you, if you are studying for your CPA exam or if you are an accounting student, farhatlectures.com can help you tremendously. I am a supplemental tool. I don't replace your CPA review course. I don't replace your accounting course. I'm just going to give you additional resources that's going to help you understand the material better, do better. Study hard. Good luck. Accounting is worth it. The CPA exam is worth it. And stay safe.